Hello there, it is Ash, and today I have an exciting luxury unboxing. Again, I'm still purchasing stuff in honor of my 40th birthday, but this is my first online Gucci purchase, and so far, I'm really loving how they packaged this item for me to unbox for you guys. I know this is a lot of green, but I love it. I understand that all of this packaging is sustainable and also recyclable, so I really appreciate that. So the first thing in here was my gift message, and then in the next envelope, there's a thank you card from Gucci. Then we have my receipt, which does spoil the surprise. Yes, I did get a shoe from Gucci. Next, I got the Gucci online exclusive reusable cotton tote, and this is a pretty large size, but I'm telling you guys, this material is very thin, so don't put anything super heavy into here. So here's the shoe box, and I love how they put brown craft paper all around the box to really help secure it. Once I do remove all of it, there is nothing else inside. Alright, so here is the shoe box, and it does have a Gucci ribbon, which is made out of 100% organic cotton. Now there is a label in front of the shoe box, and it does look like some of it got peeled off, but I think this is the style code, which you can sort of make out. Now there is also nothing outside of this box, so let's go ahead and open it up now. The first thing that I've seen here are two booklets, which briefly goes over the materials, care, and also the RFID tag, and they are in several languages. Then you've got this beautiful Gucci wrapping paper, and once you move that out of the way, there is more stuff inside. I believe these are the dust bags for the shoes. They've got a small logo Gucci on the front, and there's also a drawstring closure. Oh my goodness, there is so much paper in this box to secure and stuff these shoes. Anyways, I picked up the Gucci Brixtons. There are actually so many names for the shoe online, but it is the loafer with the collapsible heel. I also decided to get this shoe in black, and I love it because it is completely made of leather, including the bottom, which looks like it is missing the registered trademark symbol as well as this small design, so I thought that was really weird. So here is the second shoe, and it looks like they already put it inside the dust bag, so I'm going to take that out and just quickly compare the shoes to make sure that they're not used, because sometimes they could be. And so far everything looks like it's brand new, and I also wanted to see if this leather has a scent to it, which it surprisingly does not. Alright, so it also looks like Gucci puts this foam pad under the horse bit to prevent it from making a dent in your leather, but I think it's already done that, so that's not good. Anyways, these shoes are also stuffed really well with more paper, so let me quickly remove them out. But the lining inside is also black, and it also looks like the insole is black, which is great. It's also got Gucci hot stamped, and it does also say made in Italy. And then on one side, there's also the style code and the size of this shoe, which is hot stamped in a gold foil. Again, let me show you that even with this foam padding, the horse bit does leave a small impression on the leather. Now, inside of this other shoe, it looks very similar, but it does have the sticker, which usually indicates what the parts and materials of the shoe is made out of. So it looks like, according to this chart, the upper, the lining, the insole, and the outer sole are all made of leather. As for what type of leather, it is not indicated anywhere from Gucci, so I'm guessing that it's made out of calfskin for the upper and the lining. And I'm thinking that it's cowhide for the outsole based on how it looks. As for the collapsible heel, the inside has more of like a dark gray color to it. So this type of lining might be made of suede, which tends to make the heel feel more softer and also more comfortable to wear. Alright, so I'm going to try these shoes on with a pair of no-show socks to protect the shoes and to avoid sweaty feet. I also forgot to mention that I have very wide feet and I usually wear a size 9. Now it was a struggle for me to actually get my feet into these shoes, so I will be getting a shoehorn to help me put these shoes on.
Oh, it's tight. No, it won't fit my fat feet. There we go. Wow.
So that is shoe number one, and I just love how it looks. But do you guys see how instantly there is a crease now on this shoe? That is going to be actually normal, but I will be needing a shoe tree to help control the creasing. All right, now that both shoes are on, I'm really happy about the fit. I love how these shoes feel. They're so lightweight. And again, I just love the design of these shoes. It's very simple and minimalistic, but it also really helps to make a casual look feel more sophisticated. Now, I will mention that the bottom of these shoes did feel a little bit slippery, but I think once you take them outside and you start walking on them and you roughen up the surface a little bit, it will give you better traction. Aside from that, I'm really in love with the Brixtons, and I love how you can recreate the Princetown look with these with the collapsible heel. Again, the mule style is perfect for summer, but because of this collapsible heel, how you can push it back up, it makes it more of like a year-round shoe, which is practical and the reason why I really chose these shoes. But here is the final look of the shoe and a look at the leather again. Again, when you get it brand new, it's all nice and smooth, but the minute you put these shoes on, you will create wrinkles on the leather. As for the outsole, it does kind of worry me, so I have a whole entire dilemma with that, which I will discuss later. But that is pretty much it for today's unboxing. Thanks again so much for watching. I'm Ash, and I'll see you guys next time.